it's startling how strong his voice was. It was shocking. Looks like, you know, skinny English guy with scraggly hair, kind of making funny moves with his hands.
He was basically playing air guitar before there was air guitar. And clearly it was an instrument. It was part of his, the way he produced what he did.
It's kind of sort of shaking and contorting and the clenched fists and, you know, the body movements said to me, this guy's at the heart of what he sings. This is not some shtick, that this is really the way he is. Wow.
I mean, right from the beginning, he was always like that. He always like 150%. He used to go totally frantic every time and put his whole life into it. I don't know how he managed to maintain such intensity. You gotta get a hold
of your friend and love. That Woodstock moment was the real breakthrough in terms of creating his image. Somehow everybody got it. They, you know, they saw what he was about, really.
There's three things I remember about 1969. Woodstock, the Led Zeppelin album came out, and the Joe Cocker album. And that's how I sum up 1969.